Thank you very much for inviting me to share with you this interesting case. You know, when I was asked to give a presentation about complication, I remembered a patient which I have done when I first joined Dubai here about 14, 15 years ago. So I would like to share this patient with you today. This was a 72-year-old lady with a history of anginal pain for around 10 years. She's known with hypertension, diabetes on diet, and dyslipidemia, and she is ex-smoker. She had back pain, and she was referred to me by my colleague, orthopedic, for pre-op evaluation, routine pre-op evaluation for back surgery. So I did a dobutamine stress echo for her, which she was obviously positive for ischemia in the anterior and inferior wall territories. Patient was very hesitant as she was trying to avoid this long time ago, but under the pressure of the back pain and the need of surgery, she agreed to do the angiography. This is the basic angio, and you can see here that there is complex LAD lesion. I'll show you that in different views. It's complex, multiple narrowing, long lesion with a lot of overlap from other vessel. And this is probably was the best view. You can see the extension of the lesions here better. She had also a mid-segment significant right coronary artery lesion. So my strategy here was straightforward to prepare this lesion by balloon angioplasty and then deploy probably a long stent or maybe two stents in the LAD and one stent in the right coronary artery using, you know, a stent which does not necessitate long dual antiplatelet therapy if possible, and prepare this patient because of her severe back pain for surgery within 1 month to 3 months maximum. So I started the procedure by putting the wire in the LAD and pre-dilating the LAD. And at that moment, while I'm just pulling my balloon out, you know, changing the balloon over the catheter, suddenly the patient did a strong jerky move because of her back pain. And I realized that the wire came out, and within seconds, you know, the patient started to having severe chest pain. There was significant ST elevation on the monitor, and the blood pressure, you know, you can see it in collapsing in front of your eyes, going down from 140 to 70 in no time. I didn't know what's going on at that time, what happened, you know, but I had to take, you know, care of the patient, you know, hemodynamic first. So I had to resuscitate her immediately with fluids, inotropes, and eventually I had to put an intra-aortic balloon pump from the same site, the right femoral. I forgot to tell you that the radials were not suitable to start with, so I was going through the right femoral at this time. So the balloon pump was introduced from the right femoral artery, and I called for help, and the anesthetist, you know, supported me by putting the patient on good sedation and taking care of his respiration. And within a short time, the patient stabilized, the hemodynamics were reasonable, and I was able to do another angiogram to find out what happened. And that's what I found. You can see here, there's, I think, when the wire was withdrawn, suddenly, it, like a whip, it induced dissection, spiral dissection was bleeding an intraluminal hematoma, and the artery was totally occluded. So now I had to deal with this. I tried, you know, multiple times to go with the wire, but every time the wire was going into the false lumen, and the artery, you know, the moment I get the wire back, you know, you can see the same picture again. So I had to think, you know, I don't want to show you all the pictures I have taken here and the attempt to cross with different wires. However, I thought, you know, maybe if I go back and do the right coronary, I can see some retrograde collaterals that can help me to redirect the wire into the right lumen. And I did that. So I took a long shot of the right coronary artery, and I was very patient to see the retrograde, you know, collaterals. And fortunately, this was helpful. And eventually, I was able to redirect the wire into the true lumen. And after I made sure that I'm in the true lumen, I positioned my first stent, sealing the proximal part of the dissection. You can see on the second panel here that, you know, the LED flow was restored, but it's not optimum. So I thought that, you know, I did not seal with one stent the hematoma completely, so I had to overlap with another stent, and this is the result. And then after that, I optimized my stent by using high pressure balloon, and you can see that the LED now is nicely open with good flow. And you can see, I think you can agree with me that the LED is optimally open now with excellent flow. As the patient deteriorated quickly, she recovered also quickly. The blood pressure came up very quickly. And I had to take her back to the ICU overnight, observe her. Next day, she was stable. I took her to the cath lab, checked the LED, was nicely open. So I treated the right coronary artery as planned initially with one stent, and then a few hours later, I removed the intra-aortic balloon pump. The maximum cardiac enzyme for this procedure was 45 CKMB. This is the second day angiogram of the LED. And this is the right coronary artery immediately after stenting. The patient continued to follow up in the outpatient clinic after that, and you know, she actually felt very well for the first time for a long period because she was having angina for a long time, and she told me that I feel like something relieved or taken off my chest. 3 months later, she underwent a successful back surgery, and she continued to follow up in my clinic for, I think I saw her for many years after that without any problems. My take-home message here is it's very important to sedate patient properly before doing procedures, particularly if the patient is elderly or the patient has history of back pain. You know, the routine sedation that I used obviously was not enough, and if the patient was properly sedated, I would have avoided all this problem. If you have any problem, then the rule of the thumb, never panic, have control of the procedure, and use whatever it takes to pass the trouble. In my case, you know, using some poor retrograde collaterals were enough for me to redirect the LED wire cannulate the through lumen and finish my procedure successfully. Mechanical support and pharmacological support are mandatory in this situation to stabilize the patient as soon as possible and help you to finish your work, your procedure, and to minimize any complication. You know, I think you know that will help it much to reduce the cardiac enzyme elevation. If you have Impella or intra-aortic balloon pump, consider it in such a situation. Thank you so much for your attention.
Excellent, Dr. Fikri, sharing with us old case.